In a faraway valley, in a village of gnomes, is where our friend Beauregard makes his humble home. At the edge of a river, in a cottage of stone, no wife or children, he fares it alone. Day at noon, at the village's square, you're bound to see Beauregard bartering there, singing and dancing as he peddles his wares. Silly but simple, no worries or cares. At six in the evening, at the local saloon, Beauregard breaks out his bamboo bassoon. Makes the men jealous, but the ladies they swoon. Life of the party, no matter the room. By midnight the crowd is cleared out, save the usual crowd. And Beau buys the rest of us drinks and we all gather round. For the story he's told, we've all heard before, but we still hold him in high regard. The Ballad of Beauregard, the Badly Burned Bar. See, when he was younger, a lad of 18, Beauregard entered the Royal Marines to fight for his country or die for his queen. Training and combat became his routine. One moonless night, the horizon was black. Beauregard lay sound asleep in his rack. Abruptly awoken by a thunderous crack, the Commonwealth's capital was under attack. So Beau donned his armor, preparing for war, made his way up to the battlement floor, expecting to skirmish with an enemy corps. Instead he was met with a deafening roar. As a dragon flew over the castle, besieging with flames, he carefully drew the ballista and trusted his aim. With a spear in his neck, the dragon withdrew. And as for our friend Beauregard, they thanked him by making him the captain of the guard. 11 years later, 3 weeks to the day, Beau felt a rather impending dismay. He wasn't sure how, but he knew right away the infamous dragon was headed their way. Soon as predicted, just as he had feared, the flying Leviathan finally appeared. Beau told his army to ready their spears. He'd been awaiting this moment for years. In less than an instant, the monster aggressed. Beauregard stood there and puffed out his chest. He ordered his army, they were not to rest until they were free of their unwanted guest. As the dragon approached, it was filled up with harpoons and darts. It started to fall as it vaulted the wall and ramparts. And as it collapsed, it spit one final flame that left his great conqueror scarred. From then on, old Beauregard was chronically charred. 30 years service he gave to the crown, until it was time to put the armaments down. He left the great city for a cozier town, where he's not nearly as dearly renowned. Done with his duty, his service was true. Beauregard settled on what he would do. He learned a few tricks and an instrument too. Live entertainment was what he'd pursue. Now his is a story we all can admire. I'd like to be like that when I can retire. But minus the dragon and without all the fire, Beauregard leaves us enthralled and inspired. In spite of the obstacles, Beauregard made a great life. He hopes through his art he can help others manage their strife. And a statue still stands in the royal courtyard. The realm holds him in high regard. The Ballad of Beauregard, the badly burned bard. The Ballad of Beauregard, the badly burned bard. The Ballad of Beauregard, the badly burned bard.